timekeeper. You start when you start.
Okay, guys. I got a question for you. I want to know how many of you have ever driven a car. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. That's mine. I want to know how many of you know that when you operate a car, you are operating a 3,000-pound weapon. All right. Completely sober, it takes 57 feet to notice the headlights of an oncoming car. It takes an additional 128 feet to stop the car. Not too good at math, but I do believe that 57 plus 128 means your total reaction time to an oncoming car sober is 158 feet, or 14 car lengths. Now, say you're coming from a party at Carmela's house. It's 3 o'clock in the morning, and you decide to hitch a ride home in Jose's 2009 Mustang. Okay, your BAC is 0.08, which is legally drunk in the state of Texas. It's going to take you 162 feet to notice the headlights of an oncoming car. Or, you know, from 7/10 to get to 2/10, so your reaction time is double. 105 feet to stop, 257 feet to total. There's 22 car lengths total, drunk. Now, how long is 7/10 of a second, which is the amount of time that it takes for you to wreck a car? In a snap of a finger, crash your car. Beautiful heart. In the time it takes for me to slam my 120 government books on the floor, your car is total. It's not enough time. Say I love you, miss you, prayer. It's not even enough time to say. At 1/10 of a second, the front bumper and grille collapse. At 2/10 of a second, the hood crumbles, smashes into the windshield, and the griller disintegrates. At 3/10 of a second, you spring upright, your broken knees press against the dashboard, and the steering wheel spins. Now this picture of a broken arm might be hard to see. It's supposed to look like this, not that. At 4/10 of a second, the front of the car is destroyed, and has it stopped moving, anything at rest will remain at rest, and anything in motion will remain in motion unless acted upon by an outside force. I don't see any outside force here. The car is still going at 55 miles an hour. At 5/10 of a second, the steering wheel column is turned vertical. The driver is impaled on the steering wheel shaft, and your lungs punctured. This is kind of hard to see, but your spine goes like this, and this is an image of it basically like this.
Ow.
Yeah. Not good sign. At 6/10 of a second, the shoes are ripped off your feet. The frame of the car bends. Your head slammed into the windshield. Now, I don't know about you, Jose, when you drive a 2009 Mustang, are you wearing a helmet? Once. I don't. We're asking for bleeding in the brain. I don't know if any of y'all know what that looks like. Here's an image. That dark, that's blood. At 7/10 of a second, the entire car is distorted. The driver is pinned against the steering wheel shaft, and your mouth squirts blood. Shock has frozen your heart. But it doesn't matter. Do you know why it doesn't matter anymore? You know why?